Good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss about our unit 3, like environment management plan. So the plan for mitigation of adverse impact on water, air and land, energy, flora and fauna. So the definition of environment management. So the environment management is an attempt to control human impact on and interaction with the environment in order to preserve natural resources. So the environmental management focus on the improvement of human welfare for present and future generations. So the administrative function that develop, implement and monitor the environmental policy of an organization. Sustainable development, it is a pattern of resource that aims to meet human needs while preserving the environment so that this need can be met only not only in the present but also for generations to come. So the development initiatives be initiated in such a way that the future generation can enjoy the benefits of natural without any compromise. So using the resource to the extent to which it is sustained. So it's a sustained level. So the sustainable development is development that meets the need of the present without compromising the ability of future generation to meet their own needs. So like in environment, the long-term environment practice, then society, a better quality of the life for all members of the society. Then economic development combined with sustainable transport system bringing solid economic growth. So the economic society under the social inclusion bring economic prosperity. Then society and environment bring livable cities and the communities. And then environment economic bring that the business practice with a low environmental impact. So how the mitigation process we are going to apply in water pollution. So through the water, so the water pollution discharge of untreated sewage is single most important cause for pollution of surface and groundwater in India. So the large gap between generation and treatment of domestic wastewater in India. So India lacks efficient treatment capacity. So sewage treatment plants that exist do not operate and are not maintained. So the improper design are poor maintenance or the lack of reliable electricity supply to operate the plants together with absence the employees and poor management. So the untreated industrial wastewater have resulted in calcium, magnesium, fluoride, mercury and the atmospheric pollutants were more than permissible limit. So in ground and tap waters, so the water has high concentration of COD and the BOD, ammonia, phosphate, chloride, chromium, acetic and chlorobitic ferrites. So in many of the buildings along the industrial belt. So the groundwater also contains nickel and selenium, while the tap water has high concentration of lead, nickel and the calcium. So water is precious and scarce resources. So only a small fraction, about 3% is fresh water in our world. So India is the richest country in the world, but the rainfall is highly uneven with the time and space, with extremely low in Rajasthan and the high in northeast sides. So on average there are only 40 rainy days. So the out of 4000 BCM, like the billion cubic meter, the rainfall received about 6000 BCM input to use so far. So water resources are over exploited, resulting in major water quality problems. So the Water Prevention and Control of Pollution Act 1974, the preamble maintaining and restoring of the world's limits of water level of the water quality. So the prohibition for contaminants. So the every polluted industries are the municipality has to obtain consent from SPC एसीपी लाइक पीसीसीएस स्टेट पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल बोर्ड और द पोल्यूशन कंट्रोल कमिटी. सो द कंसर्न इज कंडीशन एंड स्टैंडर्ड प्रिस्क्राइब फॉर एफ्लुएंट्स देन मॉनिटरिंग द कंप्लायंस. सो द मेजर फैक्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर वाटर क्वालिटी डिग्रेडेशन द डेमोट स्ट्रिक्ट लाइक 423 क्लासेस वन सिटीज एंड 499 क्लासेस towards the arboring population of 20 crores generation about 26254 milled of wastewater of beach. Okay, so only 6955 mld is that treated. So in industrial about 5700 polluting industries in India generated about 30468 mld of wastewater out of which nearby. Okay, so the 60% like generated from large and the medium industries is treated. So the non-point sources also contributes the significant pollution loads mainly in rainy seasons. So the pesticides consumption is about 100,000 tons per year of which AP, Haryana, Punjab, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Gujarat, okay, so and Maharashtra are the principal consumers. So the domestic sewage is the major source of pollution in our country. So we want to avoid maximum that all those things, like we have to avoid the pathogenics, then the main source of water borne diseases along with the depletion of oxygen in water bodies. So the sewage along with the agriculture runoff and industrial effluents also contributes a large amount of nutrients in surface water causing the outer. So a large part of the domestic sewage is not even like a collected. This result in segregation of sewage within cities, a good breathing ground for the mosquitoes and may be the contaminated the groundwater, the only source of drinking water in many cities. So water pollution control strategy, how the water pollution control strategy are followed in five lessons we will discuss on